So today we're going to talk about sea lions. They seem like these friendly animals that just lounge around all day, but apparently that's not the full story. While sea lion attacks on humans are incredibly rare, they're still exceptional hunters with the size to accidentally squash you, and they are kitted out with everything they need to kill most things that come in their path. They'll very aggressively defend their territory, especially during mating season, and there was this case involving the Hannibal Lecter of the sea lion world, which I'll discuss later. So I'm going to go through some interesting sea lion facts, and you can decide whether you still think they're the playful, friendly animals we see at sea lion shows. These highly intelligent mammals can have some serious mass behind them, and are well equipped with sharp teeth, claws, and movable whiskers, which help them consume around 5-8% of their body weight in fish in a single feeding. This typically consists of fish swallowed whole, and sea lions can weigh anywhere between 100 and 1,000 kilos, so you can imagine why they don't get along with fishermen. After hitting their macros for the day, a lot of the flesh will get stuck in their teeth, where it will start to decay. Combine this with a belly full of fish and the remnants of vomited up indigestible parts, and you get something that you probably shouldn't let kiss you. All of this contributes to the harmful bacteria that they carry around in their mouth, adding another layer to the danger of them biting you. A good reason males may try to eat as much as they can is one of their primary life goals of being large. This gives them the competitive edge during mating season because females will typically go for the largest boys on the rock, with males being up to 4 times larger than females. And no sea lion gets as large as the Stella sea lion. Named after the typical Stella drinker, these sea lions can reach 10 feet and weigh over 1,000 kilos. This is what made them a target for prehistoric communities who used to hunt them for their meat and skin, and their whiskers were even used in the 19th century as tobacco pipe cleaners. You know sea otters? The cute ones that hold hands to sleep and have favourite rocks? Well, Stella sea lions have been known to eat them, along with pretty much anything they can get their flippers on. Although they mostly eat fish, sea lions in general are not particularly fussy eaters. They're also not that fussy about where they choose to rest, which you should bear in mind if you happen to have a boat. In Washington, these two Stella sea lions hopped on this boat for a quick ride, and now it can be found at the bottom of the Eld Inlet. Their breath may stink, but at least they can hold it for a while. They will slow their heart rate and digestion rate to conserve oxygen whilst diving, which allows them to stay underwater for up to 20 minutes. To cope with the pressure of deep dives, they will load up their muscles with oxygen, reducing the amount of compressed gases that enter the tissues, which reduces the risk of compression sickness. They also have a higher tolerance for CO2, which is usually what tells mammals that they need to breathe. Another method they might use to sink is to swallow rocks. Well, this is the best guess as to why sea lions have been found with bellies full of rocks and gravel. Sea lions are very social animals, sometimes living in groups of thousands, with males communicating through various barks, and females and pups all having their own unique vocalization. They also have this unique scent which allows them to be found among the thousands. Like theirs and everyone else's predator, the orca, they will use their communication skills to hunt together by herding fish into a ball and picking off all the stragglers. Another tool in their arsenal for this is their technologically advanced whiskers. They have some of the most sensitive whiskers of any mammal, which can detect textures and shapes as well as human fingertips. They can detect the slightest movements and vibrations of fish to precisely target the unlucky ones, and they can move them backwards and forwards to sweep them over objects and distinguish them apart, which is how they're able to catch and balance balls at sea lion shows. Their communication skills don't stop at sea lions and extend to humans. There's a reason that you see them in so many shows around the world, and that's because they're capable of understanding human language and they respond really well to positive reinforcement. You've heard of Navy SEALs, but have you heard of Navy sea lions? Their ability to communicate got the attention of the US Navy, who have trained them to be able to retrieve lost equipment at sea and spot intruders in restricted waters. They don't have built-in sonar technology like dolphins, but along with their whiskers, they do have incredible eyesight, which allows them to see at the darkest depths of the ocean. Sea lions are part of the pinniped family, along with seals and walruses. There's obvious differences between them and walruses, so I won't go over that. But with seals, it's not so obvious. The first difference is in their front flippers, where sea lions have much longer flippers compared to the seals' short and stumpy flippers. Sea lions have external ear flaps, whereas seals just have holes in the side of their head. And the most noticeable difference is that sea lions can bend their back flipper underneath their body, allowing them to walk on land, whereas seals can't do that and just have to squirm and bounce to get along. Sea lions having the ability to walk on land is quite the beneficial trait, considering this is where all their mating is done. Mating season for sea lions is like a game of risk, where the males will occupy and defend a territory, allowing the females to freely wander in and out as they choose their favourite. They will try to conquer enough land to block other males' territory from reaching the sea or other resources, which allows them to hoard it all and become more desirable to the females. If a male enters another male's territory, then they instantly choose violence, but they're typically tolerant of pups going in and out, probably because beating up children isn't a very good look for them. However, there was this incident on Russia's Mendi Island, where a Stella sea lion was seen brutally killing and eating a pup, and is suspected of doing the same to several more. This was the first reported incident of sea lion cannibalism, and even just killing the pups is incredibly rare among the species. The pup did nothing to provoke the attack, and there was no obvious advantage to killing it. It's not like any of the females were going to think, that's what I look for in a man, he's a father figure. They concluded that this was probably just a one-off case involving a sea lion with a serious psychotic personality disorder. So, on that bright note, let me know in the comments what you think of sea lions. I'd say as animals go, they're not the worst out there, and the ones that are used to humans are still very friendly. If there's any other animals you want me to look into, comment them below. And if you want to hear about the most interesting deer on the planet, click the video there.